Welcome to Learning DSLR Back to Basics. My name is Phil Dame. In this episode 4, I'm going to be covering 3 topics: color temperature, the Kelvin scale, and white balance. As far as color temperature is concerned, not all light around you is created equal, in the sense that not all light is white light. If you take sunlight, for example, the sun in the sky actually casts quite a blue hue to everything. But our own perception of things is that we know something like a white piece of paper is white, and we think of it as white. We can take the same white piece of paper and bring it indoors, which will have a much more warm or yellow hue, and we still perceive it as white. And this is just a great function of our brains, but it's something that a camera has to struggle at in terms of getting it to be absolutely accurate. And this is where understanding color temperature comes into play. The light around us is measured as a temperature, in the sense that things are hot, but not very hot, like a candle. They actually burn very red-orange. And things that burn or are very strong, like the sun, burn and produce almost perfect white light. And then, of course, we're also in an environment with blue skies and what have you. So there's lots of other factors coming into play in terms of the color cast that can affect our photos. So color temperature, you can think of all these different steps here. We've got, again, candlelight at the bottom. We've got our incandescent and tungsten bulbs in our homes and halogen lights. We have fluorescent lights. We have, of course, the sun and different kinds of situations outside that have this effect. To understand how that's measured, it's measured on what's called the Kelvin scale. And that's not as different as you might think. It's just a different scale that actually has the same degree increments as the Celsius scale. So here's a Celsius scale in which water freezes at 0 and water boils at 100. The Kelvin scale, it simply has a different 0 starting point. So water freezes at 273 Kelvin, and 100 degrees higher at 373 degrees Kelvin, water boils. So it's not that different. It's just an offset as to again, where 0 begins relative to the two. But when you look at values around these things, candlelight and how hot a halogen bulb is really burning, and how what you can say about the sun at noon in terms of our perception of it here, these are very high temperatures, even in Celsius, but certainly looks very high in Kelvin. So if I give you what the actual Kelvin values are, candlelight produces or is at a heat of 1500 Kelvin. And as things get hotter, if you think of like molten steel, it would burn so bright to eventually produce white light. And then you can think of even the campfire. You know that the blue tips of a flame are the hottest parts of the flame. And so you have to try and put your mind in that sequence, that red is not the hottest, but in fact is at the bottom of the scale, that, you know, it's smoldering red-orange all the way to bright white light and eventually the blue hot tips of a flame. And so that's your scale. You've got very low temperature at around 1500 K all the way up to 9500 K. Now, when you bring that into your camera, what we're really talking about is white balance. It's the ability for the camera to look at this white piece of paper that's got an orange tint to it because of the incandescent or tungsten or halogen bulb, and it's able to detect through an algorithm that there's an excessive amount of kind of orange color cast. And then what it does is it removes that color cast from the entire photo. So not only is the piece of paper white, everyone's skin tones look more normal, and all other colors kind of fall into place at the same time. The unfortunate part is automatic white balance doesn't always work. It can get fooled. You can have very strange mixed light situations where you've got fluorescent lights in one area and natural light coming through a window in another, and the camera is not able to detect accurately. Or if it is able to take some of the color cast out, it doesn't take enough of it out. And certainly if you're shooting in JPEG photos or shooting video, it's really important to get the white balance right, correct, because you can't easily fix it later without affecting the quality of your photo. You can make some adjustments, but if you need to make a radical adjustment in white balance, you might actually kind of hurt the end result of your photo. Luckily, your camera comes with presets that match the various or most popular lighting situations, and those are illustrated, at least for Canon, with the icons I've shown on the left. And these are the actual Kelvin values that those are kind of pegged to. So your, if you say daylight, it sees that as 5200K. And your auto white balance tends to vary within that range of about 3 to 7,000. So with your camera settings, you're able to set it or pin it to one of these settings, and that sometimes is the right thing to do. If you're having a very kind of whacked out image on your LCD, you might want to put your camera onto a specific white balance setting, and then you'll at least have consistency across your shots. So, but there are two other ways that I recommend, again, especially if you're a JPEG shooter or you shoot DSLR video. First way to get absolutely perfect white balance is to do a custom white balance. The other is to set the Kelvin value manually. When it comes to the custom white balance, what the process is that you would shoot something neutral. It can be a white piece of paper, or you can actually buy something that's like a perfectly gray target that's guaranteed to be neutral, and shoot that photo. Then you go into your camera menus. There's an option called custom white balance. You effectively choose the photo you just took and say, that's neutral. And then the camera will set that to the custom white balance setting, which you then also have to choose. So it's a few steps. So you see here, I've got my custom white balance in the Canon menu there, and right above it is the white balance with the two triangles and the dot. That means that once I've registered the custom white balance, you have to now say, I want to use it. The last custom white balance you set is saved for until you change it. With regards to setting a custom Kelvin scale, not all cameras have this feature. Something like the Canon 7D certainly does. And what that does is it allows you to set the actual Kelvin value as the white balance, and that's symbolized as a large K in the white balance icons. So what you do is you point your camera, this is what I do anyway, I point my camera to a neutral surface, could be a white paper or a white wall, or anywhere. You might just be doing this, you know, by feel in terms of what it is you want to accomplish. You move your white balance to Kelvin, and then you simply roll your finger wheel until you see the image become neutral the way you'd like to see it. And so again, here's what the K looks like, and you can see that it usually gives you an indicator that the finger wheel is the control necessary to roll it up. So you might go down to 2600K, or you might go all the way up to 7 or 9000. So that's it. If you have any questions about color temperature, Kelvin scale, or white balance, let me know. And be sure to check out my blog at learningdslr.com, or connect with me on the social web on either Facebook at Learning DSLR or Twitter, also Learning DSLR. Thank you.